Guess what? I got my new wheelchair. So what I'm going to do is comparison, because I want you guys to see the different seat functions. And my old power chair is broke where it doesn't run, but thankfully the it still powers on and the seat function still works. So now is a good time to make a video. So let's first of all. We are going to go up as high as possible. So, going up. Now my manual chair is really loud because it's so old and squeaky and stuff. Okay, here we go. And by the way, my old chair also doesn't have a seat cushion on it. That's why it looks so much lower. But even if I put a seat cushion on it, this cushion that I'm on is a little bit higher. So, let's see, we even got a couple inches of, okay, so this, obviously, even if I had a seat cushion on this thing, it would maybe raise it up to about, like, here, but, this one is obviously a lot higher. This is a permeable model F3, I believe, or was it F4, or maybe it's a F4, I forgot. Anyway, so this old one is a permeable C300. And so, anyway, this new chair is the, you know, brand new permeable. So, okay, we're gonna go down so I can be back in view. All right, here we go. This chair is brand new. I mean, like, so new that there's not even dirt on it. It's crazy. Which will be, you know me. It's not like this chair here. I'll show you this actual chair first. This is not. It is my chair, but it doesn't quite look like me. It doesn't have sides. I don't know what this is. Oh, tag, because that's how new it is. I'm telling you, it's like buying this thing off rack at the store. Like brand spanking new. One time, many, many years ago, I had the pleasure of driving a brand new car. And it only had like 12 miles or something. And actually, I wasn't driving it when it only had 12 miles. I was riding it. But, I hope I'm putting it in the right zip tie. Come on. Oh no. I almost cut a wire. That was scary. Brand new wheelchair. Down. In the first 30 seconds. Okay, everything so far is running okay. Alright, so, anyway, as you can see, it's on the chassis of this chair. Well, maybe I'll do that later. Okay, let's just do the seat functions. So, now we are going to go back. Ready? This one's a lot faster, but my old chair. Ah! Where am I going? I can't reach it. Oh man. My old chair is so old. It's like 6-7 years old. Okay. We are both fully reclined now. Now I know you can't see. As much as, okay, this will be so much fun. I ordered a string of lights, but it's for the figure on back. My friend has there, let me see that. Okay, so that's the C300 chair, that's how it reclined. This is my chair. Okay, what is it? There. It looks like the angle is definitely a little bit more. Okay, now I'm gonna roll back over there, hopefully without running into anything. And actually, while we're up like this, I'm gonna show something if I can pull myself up. Okay, see these footrests? Like, see the difference in the footrests on my old chair? I had to tape like toe guardians on to the footrest because it wasn't actually as long. Hold on. I made it. I climbed the mountain. Now I'm up here with my feet. Hey, everybody. Okay, so the old footrest. I gotta move one of my legs. Come on, work with me. It's so hard because my, like, I'm basically bent in half. Okay, there I go. Alright, so this, do you see, this is where I'm gonna lower my chair. Yeah, so we go up higher in this chair too. Or it's more fully reclinable, I guess. But, okay, so that's about at the same level. And see how this one, it like ends right there. And then I tape the shoes on there because I wear socks all the time. I don't wear shoes, and so I would run into stuff and it would bruise up the tips of my toes. And so I cut these shoes up and put toe guardians on there. But on this new wheelchair, my toes, the footrests, they made them longer. So now, like here, hold on, I gotta go down a little bit more. Mm-hmm. I should do this down too. Okay, anyway, so now the footrests are long enough where I'm not gonna need toe guardians because they actually are long enough where if I run into the wall, then it just leaves a nice gash in the wall, like what happened to my wall over there. Oh, you can't see it. But there's a nice clean line where the toe thing smashed, but at least I didn't run my actual toe into the thing. But, okay, so, oh, that's why. See, the guy came out to adjust this thing, but we lift the calf pads down, but maybe I should have moved them up a little bit so they wouldn't have, okay, well, anyway. Anyway, these things are technically long enough to cover my toes, even though I wear socks all the time, so I don't smash them when I run into a wall. Okay, so next function is the backrest. So we will do that as soon as I'm done. Okay, I'm done with this. I guess I can quit putting my finger on the thing. Okay, here we go. Backrest. Okay, I'll try to do it. I should do it back there. Alright, we're going. Ow! Sorry. My leg! Spasming. Says, what are you doing to me? Okay, this is as far back as that backrest goes. This is as far back as mine goes. Can you see it? Ellie doesn't like this at all, but it's probably a good stretch. Actually, okay, I'm gonna move up here. Try to show it kind of from the side. That is, you know, it's pretty much fully reclinable. The guy said that it can kind of invert you, which actually will do in a little bit. I'll just have fun with. So anyway, definitely, I think, well, I don't know, just the backrest. Yeah, it's probably a little bit further back than that, too. Okay, I'm going, oh, that's that chair. Alright, so now we're going up. Okay, that feels more comfortable. Good night. Yeah. Oops. That's as far up as that one goes. Let's see how far this one goes. It's gonna bend me now. It's pushing me forward. Okay. That's as far. And let's see. I guess we will show you this. I'll just do this one to see how much it's pushed my back. Well, at least that could maybe help my posture if I force myself into that. Yeah, it would. There, I'm gonna have great posture. Ow, I don't think I can sit like that. Thank goodness I'm buckled in. Okay, so next up is, I'm gonna put this back a little bit more. Get a little bit more comfortable. Okay, next up is the foot press. Okay, so that's as tight as the footrest go. I'm gonna flip that thing down so it's a little bit easier to see. I don't know. I think this chair in general does sit a little bit higher than the other chair because even notwithstanding the cushion, it looks like my chest, like the seat, the actual hardware of the seat of the chair is it's higher. Let me see. You can see it better now that I'm but see the very, like, this is comparable to that, and so the seat itself is a little bit higher, even though I'm down as low as it can go, which might make transferring and stuff more difficult, but, you know, I'll survive. Okay, so that's all the seat functions, I guess. Another difference is that, like, this, I think the legs do go up a little bit higher, but I think I'm going to have to adjust the calf pad because, the guy, he left them down low because it helps protect the, like, Achilles tendon or whatever from the very back ridge of the hard part. Like, can you see that? No. Okay. See this? This part of the footrest, he keeps the pads down low so that it cushions the foot from running into that, but I don't think I like it. I want him up because I don't know. Not working, but that's okay. He said usually when they set up the wheelchair they have to come back within the first couple weeks just to do some readjustments, but okay, let's see. Now I'm gonna put this down. Okay, well actually I won't put it fully down because I want to show something else. Okay, this is what, like, if I want to really get comfortable in this chair, see, I can do this. Like, keep the footrest out, and then recline the seat. Maybe even put the backrest back a little bit more. Just relax. just to recline. Take it easy. Maybe even watch a movie or something. Oh, this got up a little bit higher. Okay. Alright. Now I have to be careful though because This is all based on gravity, and since my legs are so weak, this foot rest, see how it'll fall in there because gravity. So I can, that would maybe be a good workout if I wanted to work out my legs. Just kind of push the foot rest up and down. But anyway, so it's, oh man, this feels really good. Okay, I'm going to put the backrest back just a little bit. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that feels great. Okay, anyway, I think I'm going to make another video of pimping this chair out, like putting all my signs, all that other stuff. Like, I've still got to hook on my my wallet, I need all my accessories. I'm back on the chair, I need to put signs on it. So it'll look just like any other chair. Nobody even knows when I get a new wheelchair because it looks exactly the same because I just covered it up. Oh, this is another thing I wanted to show though. See how the chassis cover on my old chair, how it's all like pink and purple and stuff. All this stuff. Pink and purple and stuff, and it's on this cover. That, well, on this new wheelchair, then the only color is, see, I had pink put on there. Actually, I might as well go down here. Okay, well, like, see, on the top of the chassis cover, there's hardly any color, if any. I don't see any on there. It's all black. Yeah, and then the, on the wheels, okay, the wheels, let's see if you can see that, come on, gotta maneuver, see, there's just, there's just that circle of pink around it, and then right here, there's like a little, you know, swoop, and then right back here, there's another little swoop of pink, and right here, there's a little stripe of it, and that's it. That's all the color you got on the chair, which is fine for me, because I just decorate, basically, on this stuff you can see anyway, but it is not quite as much color. I guess this is all nice and sleek. I think I'm going to duct tape my bags and make it all nice and sleek too. This will be my little black dress of wheelchairs. But anyway, this video is already going to take forever to upload, so I'm going to stop it. Bye.